esportsbets.com, a unique place for true gamers. The only place to bet on esports events. You know your way around a competitive gaming scene and are willing to take a risk? Watch regular broadcasts and earn real money. esportsbets.com. Foresight, passion, and calculation.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, from that short break. We are here with the consolidation finals of Star Series 7 being held live LAN in Kiev, Ukraine. But this is a match between HellRaisers and NaVi, both of them on home turf, and HellRaisers have taken the first map on Dust 2. We go into Inferno next, but Ven, tell me a little bit about what happened on Dust 2 here between these two teams.
On Dust 2, we saw HellRaisers give basically make an instruction video on how to sort out your mistakes from a previous game. That was basically how it's done. They started playing as a team, which we see them do from time to time, and that's when HellRaisers are one of the scariest teams on this planet. And we saw some great clutches from Markolov. We saw just a lot of great individual play and team play from them, and it looked like, as you alluded to at the beginning of the game, that HellRaisers definitely seemed warm up, and that might have not been the case for NaVi.
Yeah, I don't think it's given enough weight sometimes, right? The fact that, you know, if you play a best of three beforehand, even if, you know, you had an hour break right between, you still have that best of three where you were able to get into that competitive mindset, make sure that everybody was, you know, working well together, get warmed up, all that jazz, right? And that does make a difference. So HellRaisers, they benefited from that, seeing as how they had to play another best of three already this morning versus MyXMG, the Danish team here at Star Series, replacing Mouse Sports, who could not make it. So HR really showing up, and I think this is why we've always been, you know, kind of frustrated with HR, really, because they always seem to be so wishy-washy, kind of hit or miss, and this is since the team's inception. They've always seemed to kind of go back towards individual play whenever they struggle, but sometimes you would see that glimpse. You would see what the team is really capable of if they started just paying attention to the details and working together as a unit, and I think that's what we saw here on Dust 2 today versus NaVi. We saw a team that was working well together, covering the angles together, flashing for each other, really setting up, and you could see it across the scoreboard, everybody getting frags, but more importantly, obviously, the rounds. They just trounced NaVi on Dust 2. So now we have to see, are NaVi going to be able to bounce back? Are they going to be the ones who put a stop to HellRaisers and take it to map 3 on Mirage?
Yeah, that's it. And the worrying part for NaVi, I guess, is the fact that it was so close on Inferno last night, and now HellRaisers look like the monster team that we expect them to be.
Yeah, HellRaisers is definitely showing up, and they win in the knife round as well. I'm assuming they're going to go ahead and swap over to the CT side. I'd be really surprised if they didn't. And there we go. So NaVi will be starting on the T side. NaVi will be starting on the CT side as well.
And again, that's a bit of a difference from last night, because we saw NaVi winning the knife and starting on the CT side on Inferno. So a lot of things are not going the way of NaVi right now, because I think if HellRaisers are able to, again, ease into things and get off to a great start, I think NaVi are going to have a hard time getting back into this.
I do as well, man. I mean, NaVi, they're a team. We see those flashes of greatness as well, but before Gamescom, they seemed a little shaky. At Gamescom, you know, they fell in the quarterfinals versus Fnatic. I mean, the team that went on to get second place in the whole thing, so no shame there, but still, you know, it was a hard-fought battle, and NaVi, they could have gone through, they couldn't have gone through. It was a very close thing, but they've seemed kind of shaky a little bit in recent times, so hoping to see a bit more of the NaVi we saw at the last Star Series, you know, come alive here, because NaVi are the defending champions. Star Series 9, they took it and were undefeated throughout the tournament. So it's a big difference from then till now, where NaVi are now battling it out in the lower bracket versus HellRaisers, a team that they should be, on paper at least, they should be able to take.
Yeah, I completely agree. I actually expected NaVi to be at least in the semis for Gamescom, even though they had a bit of an up and down form curve, I guess you could call it, going into the event. I was certain that LAN NaVi, you know, the offline event, heroes would show up. And it's not like they play bad or anything. I think nobody really expected Fnatic to do as well as they did.
That's true. I mean, it was kind of, we were all wondering as well, you know, where was it going to be a Fnatic that could go the distance? And going into that last day, I remember Devilwalk just being so supremely confident. We got to talk the night before, and he was just like, yeah, Fnatic are going to win. Like, and I'm not even saying that because I'm the coach. It's just, you know, this is the reality of the situation. Fnatic are going to take this. And I was like, okay, Devil, right? Okay, man. But, Fnatic came through, and, I mean, it was down to the final rounds versus NiP on the last map in the grand finals. So NiP took it in the end, but Fnatic definitely showed that they are a team that are a top contender once again because they hold a major title. Not the same lineup. Since then, Olafmeister and Krims from LGB have been added in to replace Devilwalk and Schneider, but still a title-holding team right there with the core. So to see that they're able to get up there again and really take the fight to gain that crown, they're doing it again here. They're already waiting in the finals.
Yeah, and let's just say it. We're going to claim that NaVi are going to find extra motivation in the fact that it is Fnatic in the finals. Because obviously they want revenge.
Yeah, there is that. There is that. That's something I'm wondering about. Because you can always talk about the mindset, right? You know, when you're going into a match, and how, you know, players always claim to say, you know, we're not, you know, we know the team and we take into consideration, you know, their tendencies. But at the end of the day, we're just trying to play our game, right?
Yeah.
But still in the back of your head, it has to be like, okay, we're playing against HellRaisers right now. What I'm wondering is, you know, did NaVi go into this day already focused on Fnatic? Did they already think, you know, like, okay, we should be able to go through HellRaisers. The real beast here, the real hurdle for us to get across to get that title is going to be Fnatic. And now they have to kind of wake up and be like, whoa, 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 wait a second. HellRaisers showed up to play. We're now a map down in this series. We got to wake up or we're not even going to get that chance to play against Fnatic. We're just going to be knocked out of the tournament flat out, and HellRaisers are going to be the ones going into the finals.
Well, one would hope that that was not the case. And honestly, I don't think it's not going to be the reason that they lose to HellRaisers, if anything. They might have thought that after the first set, the B team from HellRaisers would kind of remain at the tournament, but that definitely wasn't the case. And I don't think, knowing how much these teams play versus each other and how much they've played versus each other just throughout the years, that they're not going to underestimate each other. You can't really expect Doja, Markolov, Adrian, well, anyone on the HellRaisers team to be bad or playing poorly over a long period of time. That's just not going to happen. They're too good of players to do that.
Okay, then. Well, let's go ahead and get into this first match. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. This is Star Series 10. This is the consolidation final, and we're in the second map of this best of three between HellRaisers and NaVi here on Room on Fire. And NaVi are wasting no time. Full Kevlar, couple decoys, and they've already tried to take a fight and catch Angel off guard at the top of Banana, who has been dropped down to 4 HP. So HellRaisers, they got a bit of a wake-up call already, but NaVi, rather than overcommit and potentially walk into a blender, they've decided, okay, we're going to slow down the pace a little bit and see if we can't actually catch HellRaisers over-rotating. And that's exactly what HellRaisers are doing. They've got four guys over at the B site right now, but NaVi are not there.
This is horrible for HellRaisers. Absolutely horrible. But the saving grace could be if Markolov actually holds this position and NaVi actually commit three people towards Arch. If he's able to pick up one or two frags, this could be big for HellRaisers.
Well, we have to see. He's been spotted out. Markolov already taking a little bit of damage. Dropped down to 44, but he gets a kill. And most importantly, he stays alive, even if he only lives with 3 HP. NaVi still have to worry about him being able to flank, but the rotation is coming in now from HellRaisers. And Markolov is currently caught, trying to figure out a way, trying to find a way to get in here to help his mates, who are closing in from quad. So it's just going to be the complete wraparound here from HellRaisers. Short, long, they're coming in from everywhere. And Kutcher with the CZ manages to pick up Starix in A Apartments. That's a great angle now that he's going to be able to work. Adrian moves in from long, manages to pick up 1, 2, 3 kills, and that is it. Just like that, NaVi are completely obliterated.
That's absolutely crazy, and Adrian does have a defuse kit as well, so they do manage to get the bomb defused, and holy hell. That was a retake. I'm not really even sure what happened to how HellRaisers got into those positions and how Angel didn't die throughout that retake, because he was on 4 HP the entire round. He didn't get a kill during the retake, but he stayed alive, and it definitely remained a nuisance to Na'Vi.
Yeah, I have no idea as well. Adrian with some terrific work there, just rushing onto the site. He got 2 headshots and 2 shots pretty much. Just this is another thing, is that Adrian has definitely shown up to play here. You know, we put a lot of emphasis on Doja and on Markloff, and of course Markloff top fragged on Dust 2 for HellRaisers, but Adrian had some fantastic rounds of his own, and he's definitely shown that you cannot take him lightly here. Feel like his kills on that A site proper really made the difference there for HellRaisers as well. But now Na'Vi, not going for a Kevlar helmet buying, but still investing someone in this round. They upgrade their pistols and they get a few nades to work with. So are they going to be able to take up this B site? This seems like the place to be for them, but Angel's got a Pro 90, and he could get into a pretty decent position. Adrian is right on the other side of the smoke as well, but a great flash is going to open things up, and Angel just holds down Mouse 1, does terrific damage to Edward. This is going to be Adrian, though, standing his ground, running out of bullets, but still alive.
That I was sure that Adrian was going to go down there, and he actually saves the round for HellRaisers there, picking up those 2 frags. I think Angel went way too aggressive in that scenario, but still. Na'Vi do get the bomb plant, and Doja's gonna clean up the 2 remaining Na'Vi players. But that's a successful round if you're Na'Vi. That could have ended much worse. If Angel actually plays back onto site and basically doesn't get trapped inside of a bunch of smokes and flashes, he could probably pick up a lot more and pretty easily deny that bomb plant with the help of Adrian.
Yeah, that's definitely it. I mean, but Angel, I mean, he did the best that he could at that point, which was hold down Mouse 1, cross your fingers, guess that you've got the right angle, and just spray and pray. And he still actually did quite a bit of damage to 3 of the guys. He killed 1 and did damage to 2, so that was still pretty good there from Angel in that position. Doja as well, getting 1,200 bucks off of 2 SMG kills, doesn't hurt either. HellRaisers, great buy for them, but Na'Vi, we can see, because they didn't invest that much in that second round, they've got a lot of money going into this one. Full nades across the board, AKs, helmet, Kevlar. They've spared no expense, because they need to put a stop to HellRaisers right here, right now. This is the moment for them.
This is the time, because if they lose this round, then they're back to ecoing, and HellRaisers get off to that ultimate start that they only could have dreamt of. And that's what Na'Vi are trying to prevent right now. It's not going too well, though. Angel picking up C's there in Banana, and that's a big pickoff as well, especially because the bomb is dropped all the way down in pit. Not that HellRaisers know about this right now, but this is going to take time away from Na'Vi to actually get some sort of a grip towards that A bomb site. And now,
exactly,
Angel is lurking around towards A, so they've already got the rotations in place on HellRaisers, so barring a sudden turnaround from Na'Vi towards B, this is going to be rough.
Yeah, I'm not sure if Kuchar spotted out the man there, but they have worked their way up short. Edward is going to get a drop on Kuchar. There's still Doja alive on balcony. He's about to get rushed down by Starks, but it doesn't matter. Guardian will find the headshot first, and this is working out here for Na'Vi. They turn it into a 3-on-3, but up close, point blank, Guardian gets the shot on Markloff, and he will get the plant as well. So Na'Vi, with now a 2-man advantage, hold the sight, and Guardian finds the last headshot on Adrian through the smoke in the library. Guardian, I was wondering, I was like, they gotta send him back to go pick up the bomb. Okay, but you kinda want Guardian to be in the front lines as well, and that's the reason why. 2 big kills to give the site away.
That turned quickly. I'm not really sure what happened from HellRaisers' setup right there, but that was a pretty glaring mistake. The fact that nobody covered quad to the extent where they could help out Kuchar, because Kuchar kinda has to play back at Arch at that point in the round. So either Doja or Markloff needs to cover up quad, so Na'Vi can't get that easy entry onto Kuchar all the way over an arch from quad. That's not supposed to happen. So that's unfortunate for HellRaisers, but Na'Vi do a great job of just pouncing on it right away and just decimating the entire HellRaisers defense.
Well, we'll have to keep an eye on Doja a little bit on this CT side, because he's got a very clever smoke that I really like to see up in apartments. And if you guys want to practice a smoke, if that's your position on Inferno, you definitely want to take a note there, because he banks it off of the far wall of bedroom and it falls just so that it barely allows him to see down the stairwell or pass down to boiler if he holds the angle right. And it's really tricky for the T side to spot him. So Doja's been making use of that smoke all tournament long. It's a very cool tool, and already he picks up a frag because of it. Now HellRaisers have a man advantage, but this is a pistol round for them. They've gone just with straight CZs and 1 lone P250 on Doja, because he's a rebel like that. But now Na'Vi, are they able to crack the defense? There's 4 guys here for HellRaisers with quite a bit of firepower, all things considered. And they're just going with the pre-nades right now, just trying to set things up. Doja's still alive on balcony. Gets the jump, and that's two quick kills. Kucher gets one as well, and Doja! Double spray down with the AK, and that is it. Doja has just nearly single-handedly set it up perfectly for HellRaisers. I don't know who he killed up on balcony. I think it was Zeus, but still, getting that AK and then saving the day the way he did, that was such a brilliant play.
Yeah, that round was all Doja, really. I guess, obviously, he wouldn't be able to do it without his teammates, you know, pulling the attention off of them, but getting that entry frag in apps and then that triple kill afterwards, that was just crazy, crazy stuff. And that just sends NaVi back to the Stone Ages.
They're gonna pretty be much, right?
Yeah.
You're thinking, oh yeah, NaVi, they win their buy round, great. And then no, just no, Doja happens.
Doja happens. And the biggest difference from the game last night, or Doja didn't have too good of a game versus NaVi yesterday, and now he's really shown up. So this is Doja in full-on monster mode.
Well, HellRaisers have got to be a bit careful here. They can't get too overexcited because they are giving away a lot of damage to NaVi. NaVi forced to eco here in this round, but HellRaisers kind of throwing their weight around, playing a bit aggressively, and NaVi getting some good punish out there, managing to drop Markle off low at the start and do quite a bit of damage to Adrian and Angel both. So now HellRaisers have to be a little bit more careful, and we can see that in their setup. They go back to holding B very passively, and they hold A passively as well, not giving NaVi the opportunity to close the distance with those deadly pistols.
Yeah, I like the fact that HellRaisers are playing so passively right now. That's a really good move from their side. Edward does pick up Kucher either way, though. And this could easily go south if Doja gets picked off on site.
Ooh, sick hold from Markolov, though. Doja and Markolov tag team A site. But Markolov with a very nice spray control there. As soon as Kucher gets overrun, he's just holding down mouse one and stopping NaVi from rotating around through library long. That was very nicely done.
And that was a round that easily could have led to way bigger losses if you're HellRaisers. Way bigger losses, because as you said, they've been poked down at pretty heavily, and Markolov was at 35 HP before NaVi even committed to a bomb site. Still works out for HellRaisers in the end, though, and NaVi are on the back foot.
How does Guardian live through that? I thought that a second nade had landed right on him, but look at this, Adrian. No fear. He just goes rushing forward, and this is actually going to set it up for Angel. He gets one kill. Zeus not going to stop him from getting around the corner. Angel gets another. He sucks down Zeus as well. And there's the smoke to cut off Banana. HellRaisers coming out ahead with two guys. Adrian and Angel playing so well together, holding off this Banana area. They've been doing it. I mean, even last night versus NaVi, they still showed, you know, a couple good rounds where they were able to get some good damage done. But that was a fantastic hold there by Angel.
Absolutely. They softened them up so heavily, so even if that would have been a 1v1, 1-for-1 trade in Banana with Adrian, that would have still been worth it. But look at Edward. Snuck his way up to Arch, catches Kucher off guard, and now it's all on Doja.
Yeah, it is on Doja. He has to stay alive in pit now. Looks towards Short and Starks. Great play there. Manages to catch him off guard. So Doja getting overwhelmed. It all comes down to Doja staying alive in that position, because now Angel has to rotate through. They know where he's coming from. Starks even has a molly, but it's not going to be necessary. Edward has the headshot on Angel as he tries to make his way towards the side from long. So this game, I mean, NaVi, they're battered, but they're definitely not giving up on this. It's still early in the half, and they're able to get a nice second round there on the board. Now, the real question is, you know, they're going to be forced up, but what do you think is going through NaVi's mind at this point with HellRaisers, you know, demonstrating a crazy ability to just bounce back no matter what happens?
I think they feel good about the fact that they won two weapon rounds, and right now they're thinking to themselves that, well, we lost one to an eco, and that's on us. That's not because HellRaisers are better than us. That's just us messing up, and we're not going to do that again. So I think they'll be fine, and they've gotten two rounds early on, and they have the potential to break HellRaisers here, so this is a big round for them. If they can do this, I think they're going to be perfectly fine.
That's a big opportunity, you're right, and it's a lot of money on the line for them as well, considering they just won a round. If they lose this one, they're back to $1,400 starting money for the entire team, meaning another round of eco if it comes to it, and HellRaisers cannot be allowed to have another free round to get their money stabilized again. HellRaisers having used up quite a few nades early on here, only 50 seconds left on this clock, and they have one smoke and a molly. So we have to see exactly when they're going to decide to use those, as Kucher is the one with the incendiary grenade holding towards Arch. Edward about to take the peek around Short. Is he going to get flashed in, though? You want to see that thoroughness there. Doja does manage to find Starks with a nice flash in A apartment, so that's going to open things up. And there's the incendiary raining in. Guardian almost getting dropped. in that exchange down to 16 HP.
And that buys so much time for HellRaisers. But they're not rotating yet, and that surprises me. Doja, though, is making work of the Na'vi players either way, and now it's all down to Guardian.
And then here I am talking about them needing a pistol round to build their economy. HellRaisers just clean sweep Na'vi. They deal with that buy round perfectly, and everybody lives.
Yeah, and instead of Na'vi breaking HellRaisers' economy, it goes the other way around. So now Na'vi are back to ecoing, and with the way HellRaisers have been playing their anti-ecos up till this point, this should be a round for HellRaisers, but I probably just cursed them, so
yeah,
who knows?
The curse, we'll see if it's real.
But I like the fact that HellRaisers have picked up so many Molotovs. That's going to be extremely effective versus an eco round without armor. And I'm not sure if that's something that just thought of because they knew that their opponents are not going to be able to buy up armor, or if that's something they're going to do in the upcoming Byrons as well.
Zeus is trying to kill a chicken right now, and he has to actually go back after reloading to kill it. These chickens, man.
It can't be good for your confidence. Can't kill a chicken.
Can't kill a chicken. Chicken's just running around one lol. Alright, well, Na'vi, it's pistols right now for Na'vi, so they're really just kind of taking their time, forcing the nade use, or forcing HellRaisers to use nades, rather. And HellRaisers are just perfectly content to sit back and play patient, it seems. They have rotated Angel over to Speedway, so he'll be able to jump on a site fairly quickly. But this is all going to come down to the hold now here on the A site as Na'vi prepare to close. Starx with the CZ, and they're about to round around the corner towards Long. Kuker's waiting around this corner, however, holding from Library, and there's Angel on Speedway. The crossfire is now set up, and it's just a perfect mow down. Angel and Kuker splitting the frags.
And Adrian picks up Edward over towards B as Angel finishes the round off. That was just the textbook version of how to hold versus an eco. They didn't risk anything at all. They had safe peeks. They worked together, as you saw, as soon as Kuchers actively started peeking towards Arch to pick people off going in towards CT spawn. He had a teammate with him the entire time to help him out. It's a great play from HellRaisers coming out right now. And this is, again, a huge round for Na'vi. They need to get on the board now.
It's all the pressure on them, and they don't have a whole lot of nades to work with either. This is not going to be an easy round, but it's going to come down to the aim, and Zeus is taking point here at the top. He manages to catch Kuchar off guard somewhat, but he doesn't get the kill with that Galil, and the smoke is going to go down. Zeus is fully committed to this, though, goes running out, does get the headshot on Kuchar, but there is no reply, no quick reply. Na'vi cut off in the smoke, not willing to run through and fully commit to that push, so Zeus kind of hung out to dry there, unfortunately.
Yeah, Kuchar still has a Molotov as well that can buy extra time once the smoke dissipate from mid. And you can see Angel has already rotated over, and again, if Na'vi decides to go towards this A-bomb site, this is going to be such a tough site to break through on.
But look at C's position with the bomb right now. This is making me think that Na'vi may even try and go straight through into CT, and it does look like it. Markolov is going to drop to Edward. Edward getting three kills, and this has actually thrown everything up in the air. They could go either side at this point. Doja's alive in pit, and Doja, you gotta stay alive, man. Back off. And there you go. Gets the kill on Edward. He's gonna play this pit position and just try and play the dance right now with Guardian. Seized has shown himself on short as well. Doja's communicated this to Adrian, and Doja is lining up one frag, and Adrian should be picking up the final one, but Guardian with a six spray gets it, and Guardian clutches it. Doja running out, convinced Guardian was low. Thought he could get the kill, but Guardian comes through for Na'vi and saves them in the end.
That was a massive round from Guardian. Absolutely huge. And I was 100% certain that Doja would actually manage to pick up that. And I'm actually surprised that Adrian ran at him from Library, because Doja dropped the bomb on top of Cart, and that's something that should have been communicated over towards Adrian, so Adrian can kind of just chill back for now and wait till Guardian has to commit to Doja.
Well, if anything, I was surprised that it took so long. I mean, Guardian took so long to spray down Adrian, I was just waiting for Doja to shoot him in the side, basically, get the flank.
Doja actually ran out of bullets because he used almost his entire clip trying to get Guardian through the truck. So yeah, he had to swap up for his USP, and that didn't go too well. And talking about things not going too well, Edward gets picked off by Kuchar. So
yeah,
not a great start for Na'vi. Yeah.
And I like to see this. Kuchar has shown that he's really good with the AWP on Inferno. Like, he's a he's just a consistent opper on this map because this fits his style. Holding angles like this is his strength.
Yeah.
Oh, but Guardian is warmed up now. Guardian is on the hunt. Kuchar misses another shot. Kuchar willing to take the fight with the pistol, and Guardian is just single-handedly mauling HellRaisers. He gets three frags, finally taken out here by Doja. Doja goes leaping forward. He needs to hunt down Starks, though. Starks and C's are hightailing it to B site. Perfect time flash is going to stop Doja from picking off Starks as he rounds the corner. And that is now going to be Na'Vi with the bomb site wide open to get a plant on.
This is going to be a tough retake, especially with the smokes down here. And I wouldn't be surprised if Doja just eventually decides to save it.
Well, he's still got time, and he's still right on top of this site. Starks waiting down a banana to make sure that he can't come through here, but Seize has now got confirmation, and as soon as the smoke clears, he catches Doja out. So nicely played there by Seize, rewarded for patiently just holding the angle and not giving away his position as Doja did.
Yeah, and again, I think that round comes down to Guardian. Guardian is being the big player for Na'Vi right now, stepping up and getting the most impactful frags by far. That was, I'm not really sure how he got away with three kills there. I think Merkulov probably should have been able to pick him off when Merkulov came around from quad there, but Guardian just showing how good that he can do stuff with rifles too, not just the AWP.
Yeah, Guardian is like an Olafmeister kind of. He doesn't matter, like, put a gun in his hand, it doesn't matter if it is, like, what it is, it could be a paintball gun and he's gonna kill the whole team. So like, oh, Starks, flank right now, gonna manage to pick off Doja. Doja can't turn in time, attempts a shot, but not gonna get it. This is an eco round from HellRaisers, as you all can see, so pistols in hand for them. But Na'Vi, I mean, that's the thing, we have to give credit to Guardian, basically, because Guardian has now taken two big rounds for Na'Vi, given them the means to take those rounds, but also, he's broken the HellRaisers economy, pretty much. Now HellRaisers, yep, they're forced to eco, so Na'Vi are getting five rounds on their T side, and there's still several rounds to go in this half.
And the best part for Na'Vi, really, is the fact that they've gotten to the point where they could still drop around and be able to buy up again. And previously, they more or less had to go all in on their rounds. If you lost a round, it was back to eco. So for them to have that cushion now to work with and already being up to five rounds, that's a great position to be in. So, and that most of that is thanks to Guardian.
I agree. Guardian is just, I mean, well, then it's just Guardian, right? And this is why he's seen as one of the very best. Now, let's see exactly how HellRaisers decide to deal with this. Zeus is waiting. He's going for the shot. Adrian, pull the trigger. Not going to miss it. He's going to miss the opportunity to get some damage done there. Potentially a kill, too. He was dead on. But, of course, you know, we get X-ray. The players don't. In case you're wondering, the players do not see the outlines of their opponents around on the other side of smoke and on the other side of walls and all that.
It would be kind of nifty if that was the case, wouldn't it?
Yeah, man, but this is a land final.
Seems like Zeus doesn't really care about smokes and whatnot, so he's gonna take quick care of Angel and Banana before he backs out. He does take quite a bit of damage though, but still well worth trade for him. And Adrian's gonna be alone with 44 HP and Banana, and if Na'Vi commit heavily enough to that, they should be able to take him out pretty easily, but it seems like they're content with going towards A.
Yeah, and I can picture Anders giggling right now because they just used a Molly to clear out noob corner. And Starks decides to shoot Seized in the face as well, so I'm not really sure. Huh. Na'Vi seem pretty wound pretty tight right now.
Oh, and Adren picks up one frag, and that's actually more than enough. They're not going to expect Merkulov to be out here. There's no way they can expect that, but then again, the rotation from HellRaisers has already happened. And would you look at that, Seized and Edward hung around towards the A-bomb site.
Wait, 7, 6, 5, 4... Does he get the plant?
Yeah, he's gonna get the plant.
Okay. Oof, man, that was close.
Oh, this is Na'Vi. They know this down to a science.
Now the question is, does the retake happen here? HellRaisers, two big kills from Markolov. He's walking up on short, and Kucher will get the final frag on Guardian. So HellRaisers actually turning it around. Na'Vi trying to get a step ahead and get a plant on a free site, and they do it just in the nick of time. But Markolov living with 1 HP and getting two big kills. Kucher getting the final one on Guardian allows HellRaisers to bounce back in a crucial round for them.
Yeah, huge, huge round. But I kind of question the decision Na'Vi had in their afterplan in terms of positioning, because they knew they had a free site and they were up one guy. So they could easily place two guys around the pit area and basically play off of time, have HellRaisers more or less have to run into you. Instead, they opted to take the challenges, and that didn't work out too well for them.
As we saw, Kucher peeks out of mid, decides to re-peek, and actually gets rewarded for it. I thought for a second there it would just be a 1-for-1 in the end, but Kucher gets two kills before getting taken out, and that's good enough. HellRaisers now with a bit of an advantage in this situation. Doja with a 6 spray onto Starks, pretty much dead on. Starik's not going to be too pleased with that. Starik's looking to try and return, but Markolov dodges the bullets, and now Na'Vi are kind of left out in the open here. They've used a lot of their nades. They still have two smokes, though, so they could make a B play if they wanted to, but that smoke, once again, is just cutting off bottom banana, so they are getting herded over to the A site once again.
Yeah, and this is the way Na'Vi have been playing for pretty much the entire game, and Edward gets dinked as well by Markolov and Arch, and now I wouldn't be too surprised, actually, if Na'Vi just opts to save. They're just going to try to buy as much time and give HellRaisers the idea that they still want to push and then go back. But actually, they're going to commit to this, it seems. And they might be able to catch Adrian off here before Angel manages to rotate over.
Well, Angel is in position on CT spawn, and there you go. Flat out spray right through the smoke. Now Adrian is going to be able to peek. He confirms that Seized is over in yellow. Stark should be walking up, and Stark solo drops instantly. Seized will get one kill, but this is still a one-on-three situation, and Seized is just looking for an opportunity to plant this bomb. And HR, they will let it happen. Just know it. Actually, they deny it at the last second. Markolov from Banana barely gets there in time to stop that bomb plant from happening, and that is actually really painful for Na'Vi. Because that bomb plant goes down, I'm pretty sure they're buying right now.
Yeah, they definitely would have bought if that bomb went down. You can see Stark's kind of getting ahead of himself, and he actually bought an AK regardless. But then he had enough money, so that just kind of evens everything out for them. He actually opts to buy armor as well, yeah. So Na'Vi have to look for Stark's to be the point man in this round and basically open up one of the bomb sites for them.
Na'Vi have to be feeling pretty comfortable though right now. I mean, they're going to have a pretty good buy on the last round of this half. They already have 5 rounds on the board. If they pick up 6 rounds, I think they're going to be very pleased, in fact, with their performance, because Na'Vi are also very good on the CT side here of Inferno. HellRaisers though, no slouches. Angel is going to peek out behind his molly and actually spot one man getting into the corner over there. So they know that there's one guy at top banana right now for Na'Vi. Well, what do you think HellRaisers are telling themselves at this point with that kind of information to go off of?
Well, it can mean a lot of things, really. I'm not... it just can mean a bunch of things. But that's something that they have to worry about. They're going to have to clear it out at some point or refuse to make rotations based off of it. They might have actually heard the rotations coming out, or Seast and Starks making noise, actually moving away from that corner now in Banana. So I wouldn't be too surprised if you saw Angel rotating back towards the A-bomb site.
Oh, I'm curious as well. Yeah, this is pistols right now from Na'Vi. They are pretty soft. Doja has got an HE primed and ready to go towards short, but it's going to be around long that the wraparound is going to happen, and Markolov is here. He sprays down three, gets a very clean three-kill spray there, and Doja spots the last man jumping at the pit and very casually removes Zeus and Edward from the table. Now we get into the final round here, and this is where Na'Vi are going to be able to inflict some damage. They've got enough to go for a full buy here, get pretty decent nades. Not a full buy nade count, but still good enough. And HellRaisers have all the money they need.
Yeah, they do. They've got not a single worry in the world. And if HellRaisers are able to pick up 10 rounds here, we would actually have the same result as yesterday.
Now the question is, are they going to be able to follow up on it? Look at this aggression from Guardian, top banana, but he's going to get roasted. Oh, the fire doesn't catch Seize. He lives with 4 HP, and Zeus will get a great punish, picking off Adrian. The B defense is weakened, but Kucher is already here to cut off the CT point. Smoke is going to go down from Zeus to cut off his vision. Markolov knows Edward is there, gets the instant headshot as well. So this is on the other side of the map right now. There's a second man here, Starks, working his way out from Boiler, but action is going to be on B here in a moment's time. The bomb is making its way up, and Kucher will find Zeus, who is hiding in yellow. That's not going to help. Seized! The barbecue! 3 HP? How do you only take 1 HP? How the damage?
I have no idea. I have no idea how you lose only 1 damage from a Molotov tick.
No, it doesn't even happen. If he has armor, he doesn't even take that 1 HP if the nade runs into him.
Oh, from the nade running into him. Yeah, but I was certain that he was going to get caught by at least one flame. Just a tiny flame.
Like,
and that would have done the work.
Right, you know? Like the...
It would be like a match. Match to his boot. That would have been enough. But Doja's going to clean it up.
Is gone, and so it will be a 10-5 scoreline here. HellRaisers, continuing with their strong performance from Dust 2, really. I mean, Na'Vi, they did get some good rounds in there, and they did force HellRaisers to eco, which was crucial for them to get as many rounds as they do have here in this first half. But HellRaisers definitely not slacking here. Not as even a scoreline across the board as we saw in Dust 2, but still, Doja, Kucher, Markolov, all these guys doing good work right now.
Oh, absolutely. And I think one of the reasons why we're seeing such a top-heavy scoreboard for HellRaisers is basically because NaVi opted to go towards that A site more often than they went towards B. And Adrian and Angel were both placed, I guess, at B, the B bomb mm-hmm. site for the better part. And, well, the three guys on A did a pretty good job of holding them back. But yeah, this is still not over for NaVi. If we want to take last night's game as any indication, they're actually in a pretty good spot because 10 rounds was what HellRaisers managed to get on their CT side that time around. And that was enough for NaVi to close it out. They got 11 rounds on their CT side, so they're not out of it at all, but I think they definitely need the pistol round to get a good start off going, because if they end up starting from behind once again, that might be enough for HellRaisers to just race into the finish line.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised at that point. For HellRaisers are really well placed right now to just take away this map. If they were to do it, this would be huge, because the same sort of thing happened to NaVi on Dust 2. You know, HellRaisers take the second pistol round, and then it's practically lights out. Despite the fact that NaVi have maybe a bit more of an edge, seeing as how they're on CT side Inferno now, so it's not totally unreasonable for them to be able to do the run back. Is just going to be crazy difficult. And Guardian getting tagged down to 10 HP already at the very beginning is not going to help things for them.
It isn't. And Starks is fairly aggressively pushing down Banana right now all by himself. So he gets caught out by Kucha or Doja here. That could spell disaster for NaVi. But it seems like NaVi are pretty confident in the fact that HellRaisers are going to try to make a move towards that A bomb site. And as of right now, you can't really fault them. They've got three people placed up in second mid right now, and it's only really Doja that's working towards Banana.
No, I'm not sure if he spotted the second man there. He definitely spotted Kucha and put some damage on him, but Starx has got to be careful about this angle he's holding. He is going to have Seized rotating in to help him now, though, and those are the two guys that we expect to see on this B site. The defense is still solid on the A side for NaVi, but it hasn't really been tested. It's going to be Markolov kind of lurking around, seeing if he can catch somebody rotating towards that B site eventually, because HellRaisers, they've got two flashes, no smokes, unless they've thrown them out now, and yes, they have. So now we have to see the execute towards B. Can NaVi withstand the pressure? And Angel instantly picks off Seize through the smoke. It's all down to Starks now, alive, alone. He gets one headshot, but he can't stop the plant. Two headshots, just kills raining in left and right, and the last man alive, Doja, only 27 HP, and Starks will pick it up. A near perfect retake from NaVi. They never even really lost control of the site.
Yeah, that's exactly it. They never really lost control of the site. Starks, they're hiding behind the pillars, doing insane work. I have no idea how he did not just fall. He barely took damage, even.
You know why? Because as soon as he saw somebody, they died.
Yeah, that's also headshots. A good way of preventing damage. That is a pretty good way, and that has to be a big boost for Starks as well. Him picking up 4 kills now puts him at 8, so he has already matched his total for the T side in that one pistol.
That's pretty impressive. That was really nice to watch. I was watching Starks that whole time too, and the way he kept his cool, it wasn't spray and pray. He was just clicking and getting the shots when he needed to. So, especially once Seized got dropped so quickly, I thought, okay, well, this is where Starks gets overrun. He's not going to be able to withstand the pressure. But HellRaisers, they just weren't able to deal with it when it came around to it, because I think they tried to wrap around through CT very quickly as well. There's a man rotating there, and that kind of worked against them.
Yeah, actually, Doja was the first guy in towards spawn, and he actually didn't commit towards the site. He wanted to stay behind the ruins because he had heard Guardian shooting from CT spawn through the smoke, so he was expecting a quick push in through from Guardian, and he wanted to have that ability, really, to pick him off, which is fair enough, but I don't think he's going to do the same thing again until they have full control over the site, seeing what Starks just did to them.
Well, let's see now how NaVi can, if they can weather the storm here. The anti-eco is closing in, and HellRaisers, they're just slowly taking their time. Guardian peaks, and that's three guys nearly shooting at him, and he still lives with 18 health. So that's a really nicely done there by Guardian, at least dodging bullets like a madman. Angel is going to just manage to pick up one kill, but the rest of the defense is going to falter here. NaVi will not be able to stop this plant from happening. Zeus takes a bullet to the face already down in pit, and that's certainly not going to help things. He has to dance good now to keep himself alive, because it's crucial that he stays alive at this point. Doja looking to catch Starks as he rounds the corner, and he's not going to get it, but Adrian is still alive, and Adrian on this A pit, taking a run-and-gun fight, just trying to buy as much time as possible, but he gets caught in the end. Seized coming in from B, just standing on that site, will stop him from running. And Navi will pick up this round, but it's a costly round in the end. A plant for HellRaisers and three kills. HellRaisers did what they needed to do.
Yeah, absolutely. That and more. Just get from the point on where they get the bomb down, that's a really good, really, really good eco. The fact that they managed to grab Suze from pit there as well, that just adds to it all. And you can see that Navi are completely bankrupt. So if HellRaisers are able to get something even similar to that kind of round, they don't even need the bomb plant at this point. If they can kill three people from Navi, that's going to make it so that they're going to have to buy up FAMASs when HellRaisers are going to come out with AKs.
Yeah, exactly. The firepower difference is going to be just a little bit one. You know, it's not going to be too easy. And once again, it's going to be just... This has been a very common strategy for both teams, in fact, on their CT side, just smoking down bottom banana and stopping anybody from taking any kind of early control there. This time around, it's not just Starx holding solo, though. Seized is really staying over there for quite some time, not really willing to rotate off quite yet.
Yeah, and that's actually something I completely missed, the fact that HellRaisers bought up, because they did get the plants, so... In both rounds, actually. And this is probably the safest kind of buy you can do, actually, because even if they lose the round, as long as they do damage to Na'Vi, Na'Vi are going to be pressed for money, and... With the bomb plant here, HellRaisers are going to be able to buy up again, but Seized is doing a great job in banana right now.
Yeah, staying alive, playing the angle well, gets dropped down to 20 HP, but still, takes a kill, takes the info, and backs off. That was very well played by him. Starx gets one kill as well before getting taken out, so right now Na'Vi are doing what they need to be doing. I say that, and then Markloff manages to catch Zeus off guard and get a free kill, bringing it back to a 3-on-3. Edward is still alive on balcony overlooking short, however, and he's got his eyes on this A site. He's going to be the point man here for Na'Vi, and he gets the first frag. They still haven't dealt with him. Doja goes down, and Seized will find Kucher. Edward, playing a key role, comes through for Na'Vi and just locks that site down.
Yeah, real good. And best of all for Na'Vi, they prevent the bomb plant, so there's not going to be a new buy coming out from HellRaisers. They're going to stick to pistols for the most part. And finally, Na'Vi have the opportunity to actually get some room. One thing is they're going to be able to nearly equalize the score, but they're also going to get the opportunity to build some bank.
Yeah, that's the important bit here, the money right now. Guardian, is he going to take this fight with Kucher? It does drop him down to 38. So a little bit of an exchange already at the beginning here to start this round, but HellRaisers, as you said, they're on pistols here. CZs, P250s. Interesting, Adrian is kind of like a Freiburg right now, basically, because he goes CZ on CT side, but then on T side he goes back to P250 for his pistol. And yeah. this is something that... Well, that some pros have talked about, the fact that, you know, the CZ, it's brutal on CT side. Like, you can just mangle people with it. But then P250 seems to be more advantageous for the T side, because you're maybe taking more long-range duels and fights with it. So the P250 a bit more accurate in that case.
Yeah, I think that's the big reason why some teams opt to do it. And then we're going to see a push-up into mid-air from HellRaisers, and Guardian and Zeus quickly dispatching of everyone from HellRaisers. And that's, again, a pretty textbook anti-eco from Na'Vi.
That was very nicely done there. Well, that's how it's supposed to hold, right? Especially if they're running through smoke, you don't get flashed. Not, you shouldn't die, and you should basically just wipe them out. So, Na'Vi, that's about as good as it gets for them as well, because not losing anybody means that bank that we talked about is starting to develop. They've got three guys floating above 5k, so they're guaranteed a buy in the next round, regardless of the outcome of this one. Which is good for Na'Vi. They can't let HellRaisers start to get too far ahead here.
Doja actually makes the most out of a pretty awkward situation here. They go for 2-for-2 trade and banana. And that looked like a pretty grim situation for HellRaisers, actually, because they had players trapped inside of Molotovs. So I'd say that trade was definitely beneficial for HellRaisers.
I think that was the best case scenario there. I think that's one of the few times we actually see those nades work so effectively. And yet Doja somehow, in a situation he shouldn't be able to do much in, he comes out ahead, he gets two kills and saves his team, basically, the round.
Yeah. Now it's all... Everything in this round kind of falls down to how HellRaisers are able to read what Na'Vi's setup is going to be like. If they figure out that Suze is alone towards B, then obviously that's where they'd want to go. But they need to sniff out something for the two guys holding on A from Na'Vi at any point before, well, early enough for them to make a rotation. But it seems like they're just going to commit to the A bomb site here.
Yeah, 30 seconds left. They're running out of time. Nades are going to go through, but Markloff runs right into Edward, who again is holding on that balcony position. And Edward and Guardian just... They're making it look easy at this point. Edward, that's what, like two back-to-back rounds where he just hasn't seemed threatened at all? Two back-to-back buy rounds from HellRaisers.
Yeah.
That is.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think that was a bit of a botched flash from the HellRaisers player in mid. He was supposed to flash over towards apartments, so Edward would have been flashed, but that wasn't the case, and Edward made pretty easy work of the incoming HellRaisers player.
That's what we expect to see from Edward, especially if he's holding that position. I mean, it's such a strong one. It's the one that Forrest plays, it's the one that Doja plays, and just a very, to great effect. Now, however, once again, HellRaisers really wanting to put NaVi on the defense on this B site, clearly. I mean, this is round after round where they're really taking a fight early on and willing to take the damage as well, because you got the nades, you got the mollies, and then you've got the bullets coming at you. But HellRaisers, they get the map control, I guess, is what they're really going to be happy with here.
Yeah, and one of the things that HellRaisers were very successful with yesterday was actually catching off Starx and Banana quite a few times. So I think that's what they're looking for right now as well. But this time around, NaVi have definitely made some improvements to how they're playing that, and they're not allowing for a lot of room to be made for HellRaisers.
When we approach the 45 second mark, NaVi are out of smokes, but they still have a molly on Seized and a molly on Edward. So they could buy some time on this B site right now if Seized were to use the incendiary. He's just waiting for the opportunity. He's probably going to throw it out right now. It should go down. Zeus stopping this push already, but Doja is going to fall. Seized picking up another frag, and Seized is just catching him as they come in. He's pulling a Starx right now. Starx still alive, but not for long. Markeloff will remove him, and Markeloff actually getting a sick double kill. Starx and Seized both dropping to him, but that's the best that HellRaisers can do in that situation. Three members live for NaVi at the end of the round.
Yeah, again, NaVi come out ahead, and now HellRaisers are back to ecoing. Luckily for them, though, they do have enough cash, so they're going to be able to buy up next round, and probably the round after that if they continue to lose here. And all that's in Navi's mind at this point is basically don't lose too many members in these rounds.
Yeah, and NaVi, I mean, they just continue to beat them up. Seized. I mean, Doja was trying to get up to top of Banana very quickly there, but Seized takes the aggressive peek and actually comes out ahead. Guardian, in the meantime, has picked up his favorite AWP and has picked up a kill with it as well over on short. So now HellRaisers, at least they have the information that, yes, Guardian has an AWP. Edward has a rifle, much to Markov's dismay.
And seems like that's going to be about all they get out of that eco round.
Wow.
As Edward cleans up Kutra as well. So, yeah, another great anti-eco from NaVi, and HellRaisers are none the wiser, but they do have the money to buy, and I'm interested to see if Markeloff is going to buy an AWP. No, he's actually going to stick with an AK. Well, curious to see if he wants to take the challenge to Guardian here in mid. But that's not going to be the case. And, yeah, with that information that Guardian actually has an AWP this time around, I'm curious to see whether or not they're actually going to play for that, if they're going to try to avoid Guardian, or if they're actually going to bring it to him in mid.
Well, we can already see how they're adjusting. They don't want to give him the opportunity. They go for the smoke at top mid already, but then they go up second mid there, HellRaisers. So they don't want to give Guardian an easy shot. Because sure, they're going up second mid, but you can be sure that they're watching apartments as well. So if Guardian were to take a peek, he does it every now and again, but if he were to take a peek, HellRaisers would get a freebie kill there. HellRaisers instead just try and rush through the smoke now, up quad. They know where Guardian is playing from now, and they're just trying to put the pressure on him as quickly as possible, but Starx has already pushed down bottom Banana. Seized has got his back as well, and they're just closing in on HellRaisers from all sides. There's nowhere left for HellRaisers to go. They just have to go forward, but it's not good enough. Kutcher will get caught by Seized in the end, and three members once again living here for NaVi.
A great hold from NaVi, but again, I think that was a bit half-hearted from HellRaisers since they were pushing up mid, because there was really only one guy who pushed up towards Guardian there in Arch, and he got picked up pretty easily by Guardian, and from there on out, they just kind of had to chase Guardian instead of smoking Guardian off and then trying to push heavily towards that quad area, and they got stuck in mid because of it.
Well, isn't that, I mean, the thing is, it's kind of like when you've got pistols, and sometimes you'll do this, and the AWPer that comes to mind who just has a sixth sense and knows how to deal with the situation best is almost like Kenny S, right? But
yeah.
You rush. If you're going to commit and try and take out Guardian, either you smoke him off, as you said, or you go three guys at once. And maybe he takes one of you, but you kill him immediately as well, and that opens up the area. But you're right, there was that moment of hesitation, which is why I hesitated as well. I was like, actually, what the hell are HellRaisers doing? Because they just kind of stopped. in quad and didn't really go anywhere with it.
Yeah, and players like Guardian are going to take full advantage of that. We saw Starix with a quick rotation down banana also getting a piece of the pie. So what HellRaisers need to do is basically be more determined in what they want to do. They have to commit really hard to either decide that we're going to take out Guardian and he's going to be our ultimate goal to open up the map, or we're just going to leave him off and avoid him as best possible.
Let's see, Angel's going to be flashing around, smoke to cut off Guardian as well, but Edward is still alive in the pit this time, not on the balcony. Nice flash there to actually blind Edward as they try and push up here, but HellRaisers all on short. They've smoked off Edward, but that doesn't stop him from catching Markolov getting on top of that van. Kucher will finally hunt him down, and there's two kills. Angel and Kucher managing to open things up somewhat here on Na'Vi's side, but Zeus steps in and gets a double kill, and he could even go farther, but there's only 8 seconds left on this clock, and HellRaisers, they just don't have time. Angel has to back off.
That's so unfortunate. HellRaisers had the idea. As soon as they managed to pick up Starix, Angel actually turned around instead of committing to that quad push to check behind, and he found Starix all out in the open and mid, and he was able to pick him off. And at that point, HellRaisers were so eager to actually rotate over towards the B bomb site, but because they waited such a long time before they tried to push towards A, there was just not enough time to make that rotation, and that would have been a completely open B site for HellRaisers to plan in.
No, that would have been perfect. And Doja has now been cut off from his compatriots. He's at top banana alone. Guardian is about to pick into two guys, but they've got nades in their hands. Guardian gets a freebie and even gets out in one piece.
That does a ton of damage to Adrian as well. But Adrian returns the favor.
Oh, that was very nice, but Guardian is going to get taken out. Adrian has woken up now. It's his turn to lay down the pain. He's going to get two kills and open up this A site. The bomb plant is happening unless they can find the angle, and C's just barely missing it. Edward is now going to go for a barbecue on that A site and force Adrian into that corner. But this is a 3-on-3 retake, and Doja has the high ground looking towards Edward, and he finds the kill. Seized is now caught in a box. And they're both stacked up. Seized and Starix are both coming in from long. They know damage has been dealt to HellRaisers, but they still have to find the shots. And there you go, the first one for Seized. Finds Adrian. Good kill there, but Markolov is still alive in the back corner. Seized is going to spot him out, get the kill. He looks for Doja, not going to get it, but still, they have to get on this bomb. They have to go for the defuse. There's no time to waste, and there's only 1 second left. Seized will not get it. What the hell's going on?
I have no idea. That was so close. That was millimeters away from actually getting that bomb defuse off, and HellRaisers can count their lucky stars that that just happened, because they lost control of a round that they should have had with ease, actually. I think Doja kind of botched a couple of shots there from Pit onto one of the Na'Vi members coming in towards the site, and that definitely should have been a kill, but somehow it works out. That's really lucky on HellRaisers' part.
Obscene. Oh, double spray, triple spray, quad spray. Yes, please. Thank you, Starix. Sick play from Starix. Zeus almost casually walks in and shoots Angel, but Starix with the quad spray down banana. At the start, you're almost like, okay, you know, he baited Seized, whatever, right? But then he just came in spades. That was sick.
And if that's the kind of result you get from baiting out teammates, by all means, you can bait out teammates any day of the week. And that just spells doom and destruction for HellRaisers. Now we are at match point. HellRaisers have to force up with the pistols, and I have a hard time seeing this not going to three maps.
That was a thing of beauty. I'm just replaying it in my mind right now, Starix. He just kept control as well. And that's the beauty of having an M4A4 in that sort of situation, right? If he had an M4A1, he was dead. Like, he gets two guys, and then he runs out of bullets. But because he had the extra 10 bullets, the quad spray is possible. Zeus will get the final two frags, but that is going to be it. 16-11, and on the second map of this best of three, Na'Vi bounce right back into it. They've woken up, and now we have to see, are HellRaisers going to be able to come in and actually get that spot in the finals on Mirage, the final map of this best of three? It's all going to be decided here in 6 to 7 minutes time. We're taking a short break, and we'll be right back.